Sorry, I'm just gonna fan guy for a little bit.
So basically, I use a voice and stuff. And it's a little bit irritating sometimes when I communicate with my wife, anyway.
I freaking love Mind Flayme and all of that. That's my favorite thing in the world. And all. Okay,
that's my favorite thing, too. Hello, everyone. How's it going? Welcome.
I don't know how it's going. You should be telling
us
how Station it's going.
The GameStation podcast featuring people that are the best entertainers in the world.
Oh.
In the world.
Amazing, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that concludes this week's yes podcast.
Sadly, some people could not be here this week. Some people being Dodger because of reasons. And reasons.
Good reasons.
And Total Biscuit is busy doing actual work because he actually...
Girl reasons.
Because he actually does things unlike us. So...
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Good story.
That's that. So they put me in charge for some reason. I wouldn't have done that, but I don't know. It's a thing. So let's welcome all of our guests today.
First, this is gonna be a long one. I'm warning you right now.
I'm gonna delay this.
If you don't have a tolerance for pain, just walk away.
Well, okay. First, we have Jesse Cox. Jesse, how are you today?
I'm doing pretty terrific.
Mm-hmm.
How's everyone else doing?
Fantastic.
I've got the hair of a man who hasn't showered.
Okay.
I've got the stare of a man who hasn't seen anything but a computer monitor. And I've got the skin of a man who needs a date, ladies.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, so that's Jesse. He's here a lot because he has nothing better to do. Mind Flayme!
Really? Hold on! I might be the only person who hasn't missed an episode of this podcast. I think I missed once.
So your statement would be untrue. You have missed an episode.
But that wasn't even an episode. If you watched it, that wasn't an episode. It was pretty garbage. Mm-hmm. So I'm just saying, like, I feel like TGS should be paying me for this. Millions of dollars. That's what... I'm not misjudging the worth of this podcast, am I?
No. I mean...
No? Millions of dollars.
We get as many views as ABC or NBC or, you know, a major broadcasting network, so it makes sense that we should be paid like it. Clint Ackleman, Mind Flayme, welcome to the show. You're here instead of Dodger.
Yay! Although I would have liked to have seen Dodger today to congratulate her on her many, many mustache talents.
Yes, indeed.
Mustache talents.
Mustache
at Mind Flayme on Twitter, youtube.com/MindFlayme, and
okay, we're not at that part of the show
5 days
okay.
a week.
We're not
twitch.tv/MindFlayme.
We're not at that part of the show.
No, okay. I don't care what part of the show
I
it
just
is.
Hit my elbow.
I'm here. I got it. Oh, by the way, you should probably like tweet or
I did tweet
post something on Facebook saying the TGS podcast has started.
I did.
No, you didn't. You
yeah,
liar.
I did.
You lie. I'm looking
Hi, Mark.
For it.
How are you?
Mark,
I'm fine. Hello, everybody.
Hello, Hi. Mark. How are things in your life? Who are you? What do you do?
My name is Mark, also known as Markiplier. I do YouTube videos and all that jazz, just like pretty much everyone else in the world. But I have absolutely nothing going on. I sit at my computer all day, wondering what game to play, and end up doing.
Fuck you.
Nothing. Yeah, my games.
You and your amazing voice and your looks.
I know.
And your camera. And hi, I'm Mark, and I'm fucking fantastic.
I know.
Oh,
you're
Mark.
I'm already instantly jealous of you. Go to hell.
My life is a dream. My audience is like 90% women, and they just like send me naked pictures all the time. It's horrible.
Yeah. Yeah,
that
Jesse.
Sounds like a crisis.
I'm hoping you're lying, or else I will kill you and wear your skin.
No, it's more like 45.
Kickstart by Mountain Dew, promoting murder and skin wearing for over 25 years.
Yeah, Jesse, some people like Mark and I have amazing YouTube voices and fans and everything.
Yeah. It's some burden, really.
It really is. I mean, and, you know, I felt like since Total Biscuit isn't here, and he's very good at structuring the show, that I would harness his energy by buying a top hat.
Ooh. Is it hat day? Nobody said it was bring a hat to work day.
Well, you don't need to be a hat because you're not Total Biscuit.
Yeah, but still, I mean, one person wears a hat.
My powers are gone. Hold on, let me get this. How does he do this? Okay. Okay.
I think first, he gets a hat that actually fits on the head.
This isn't even good. You can't even see this on the damn stream. It's too.
He hasn't worn a hat in, like, a top hat in forever.
Hats are for losers.
Oh my god! Does everyone just have a top hat?
I don't. Sadly, I do not.
So oh, wait, that's not a top hat. That's like if.
That's like TV half a top became, hat.
Yeah, it's like if it became Heisenberg.
Yeah, that's a curved fedora, I think.
It is.
Yeah.
Well, you know way too much about hats.
Mm-hmm.
A man with such wonderful hair.
Righto. Welcome to the TGS podcast.
I'm so glad that relevant topics are coming out of all of our orifices.
Well, it's my podcast, and maybe you can listen to what I say instead of talking about what you do on the podcast. So today, let's talk about what we've been playing. Jesse, what have you been playing?
Well, TB, I have been playing StarCraft II out the wazoo. That rhymed, and I feel good about that.
Oh, yes. Really.
Of course.
Yes, really. Quite. So, I can't even look at you.
All right, I don't need to harness it right now.
So I've been playing StarCraft 2 like crazy. I freaking love that game so far. And other than that, before Monday night at midnight, I was playing more Ni No Kuni. I'm trying to beat that game, but I keep getting caught in the wonderful I must level up 12,000 hours a day rather than actually play it, because I'm like, what if I get to the final boss and I can't beat him and I gotta go to it again? So I am preparing and I'm very excited. I love that game and I'm trying to think of anything else, but
I know one thing you're not doing, Jesse. No. You're not doing your dailies.
That's true. I'm not. I feel really bad. Mm-hmm. I keep saying I'm going to start doing WoW dailies again and then I just don't. However, I am really excited because if you watched this podcast last time, I said how much I absolutely hate the dailies, and that's the one thing in Mists of Pandaria. I was like, I like the story, I like the graphic changes, I like everything, but the dailies are awful, just awful. There's so many. And so, in a thing on MMO Champion, one of them, it might have been Zarahim, I don't know who it was, one of them said, if there was one thing they could change, it would be the frequency and number of daily quests. And I felt really good. I was like, thank you. My anger is validated.
Well, that's just because they made it. So it's like dailies is like completing your like to-do chore list.
Oh, it's I mean, that's what it is. Because then in order to get anywhere, you have to do them. So it's like you need to do 25 a day every day so you can get all the things. Then you can move on to the next dailies. They progressively, as the more expansions they released, the more dailies became like just a downward slope of awful.
I have a tip for you, Jesse.
You do?
Yeah, if you'd like to get carried through the Kirin Tor offensive dailies, all you have to do is log on WoW at 3 p.m. Eastern and join my group, because I do it every day.
I don't need
to
be carried.
Why don't you do that and just auto-follow, and I'll go
Mojo's,
kill everyone.
Mojo's pretty beast on his off-spec, but with that said, I just, oh my god, like, it's just Blizzard. You gotta stop with the dailies. I know that's like your thing to get people to keep playing.
But you need the 496 loot.
How is that like the thing to keep people playing? Like, I know it'll get them back. Chores.
Dude, it's obsessive compulsive. It's obsessive compulsive. It's everyone who's like, I gotta keep playing because if I don't get to the next level, I won't be able to raid with my guild, which are my friends, and that's the reason why I play, because it's all social. Shotgun blast in the face.
Has anybody?
By the way, I have the smallest muffin ever. smallest muffin ever.
I mean, I think we already all knew that.
The chat didn't know I have the smallest muffin ever. It's banana nut, and I got it from a bakery here, and it was 50 cents, and I was like, can I have a banana nut muffin? They're like, would you like the big one, which was like this big, or the small one? Or in LA, this is a small.
Or the LA model size.
That's what it is. I assume it's for models, which is perfect.
It is. That means they mistook you for a model. That you
they probably did.
Oh, yeah.
They were very drunk. I walked in, they're like, hi, you beautiful.
All right, then.
It has nuts on it, too. They're like, it's extra healthy.
It is extra healthy. If you add nuts onto anything, it becomes extra healthy.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure about that.
Add nuts?
I think I saw a study on it. So, I mean, that makes it true,
just
right?
Just add nuts.
Don't you do it! Don't you do it, you son of a bitch!
We all know what's happening. Anyway, Mark, what have you been playing this week?
I'm kind of behind the times. Just casually, I've been playing Killing Floor in Tropico 4.
Oh,
trying
wow.
to kind of stay away from SimCity for the moment, but I've only recently started getting into Killing Floor just when I did it for a video with Yami Mash, who was on the podcast a while ago, so I've kind of become addicted to it as of late. Other than that, nothing. Absolutely nothing. I used to, I was trying to get back into World of Warcraft for a while. The last time I played seriously with Wrath of the Lich King, and I mean, I tried my best. I was in a top 150 US guild, but that was about it and drained my life away. So I commend you guys for keeping up with it. That's amazing.
Oh, I don't. I've given up.
Oh, you don't? Oh, okay.
No.
Mm. Yeah.
By the way, I'm not supposed to interrupt you. I was told in chat, who let this fat guy talk? Let Mark speak. So
what?
Mark?
You... My fans are a bunch of weirdos if they're here. I'm gonna tell them straight to their face, and they'll be okay with it. Like,
yeah.
I just tell them, like, my fans, settle down.
Just ignore Clint Hackleman. He just has things that randomly go on sometimes.
Don't know what you're talking about.
I mean, I don't either. Clint, what have you been playing this week?
Well, I have been playing SimCity. Mm-hmm. I have also been playing World of Warcraft, trying to get geared up for the new dungeon. I just hit item level 482. So this morning I was running the new dungeon.
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, the server did a restart. And when I queued back up, it queued me as a tank. And I got right back in. And they're like, you're a kitty, you're not a tank. And they booted me out of the raid. So then I had to get back in the queue and start all over. But there was a couple interesting games, actually. Did you see, or maybe you guys have heard of this one. I just downloaded it. It's a beta. It's some sort of space simulator. I'm looking it up right now. Somebody in chat's probably going to get this before I get it.
Oh, no. No one in chat's going to get it. Chat is like, Mark! I want you inside me. We picked a winner today. Yeah. I am honored. I don't know. Mark's fans, if you're looking for someone else to subscribe to, that is nothing like the guy you love that you're probably going to hate. Sign up, kids.
What was the... It was just Star Conflict, maybe?
Star Conflict, Star Drive...
Okay, they just had a promo for it on Steam the other day. If you bought it, you get beta access right now. And it's some sort of real-time strategy game. And it costs $25.
I found one.
Anyway, I bought
MMO.
That, and I tried to play it, and it was just... You know, I thought it would be sort of like FTL.
Shouldn't you know the name?
It wasn't. I have it on my freaking list. You know what? I'm just going to go to my Steam purchases.
Look, Dodger literally just gets up and leaves sometimes.
It's true.
That's what this podcast is like. Sometimes you'll just walk away.
Yeah.
Hold on.
It creates mystery. People are like, where'd she go? Is she saving the world? Is she, like, talking
to
her cat?
Thank you for your purchase.
That's more likely.
Doesn't even tell me what.
Well,
while he's looking,
Krendor, what have you been playing this week, dear friend?
Oh, I've been playing so many things. I've played some WoW. I ran the old raids. Because you can now, like, solo the old raid, so I was doing them with my friend, and we're just going through, and it's nostalgia fun. It's nostalgia fun.
Star Drive beta.
And sorry, that Star was Drive. It. Yeah, that's what everyone was saying, Star Drive.
Okay. Yeah.
And, what else have I been doing? I played a couple games of League of Legends. I logged on StarCraft 2 just to, like, update it, and didn't play it. And, what else did, I don't know. I've watched Netflix. Oh yeah, I played Blood Bowl, of course. Of course. It's not, what?
Nothing! Continue, please! This is really interesting.
What? You were laughing. Why were you laughing?
That's what we do on this show.
I wasn't laughing. Now I'm laughing. Okay, so I was playing Blood Bowl, and I know you don't like Blood Bowl, but I played against Dodger this week, and that was a great game, and I was happy about the outcome, which means I am now maintaining my second place spot, and hopefully TB can lose so we can be tied, and then I play TB next week, so that'll be fun. Even though it's kind of like a playoff match, because like we're both already in the playoffs, it's just it's a thing. And then, yeah, I saw that you tied your Blood Bowl match.
I don't think you're supposed to be spoiling this stuff.
Oh, well, it's only spoilers for people watching it live.
Oh. What?
And they don't care.
Oh, all right, yeah, I guess you're right. No one really cares. Look, if I stopped caring, they stopped caring. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my team got murdered this week. Mm-hmm. We tied, and I don't know how we still tied, but I got brutalized. Like, I got spanked around, so.
Listen, it was
two dead guys, 7 KOs. My field was empty by the end. I still scored a touchdown. I was like, whatever.
I mean, you were playing Bebop, who's like also like you have like a combined total of 1 win and like 7 losses or something.
Yeah, but his guys are in. I don't know why they kicked my ass. It was sad. I don't know what's happening on Clint's screen. I think he just left.
He kind of, like I said, watch for the random moments of Clint Hackleman. Sometimes they take over. It's just, it's part of
him. I got a message
him.
From somebody. It was from Zymusius. He says, I want to post a message in the widget. Where's the freaking widget? Podcast needs more Yoshi. So I put Yoshi on, even though they can't hear it. They've heard
Mark,
it enough times.
How you
times.
Doing? I feel like you're going to be the saving grace of this podcast.
I am
he
fine.
Really is.
Do you want me to tell some random story that maybe can get
sure.
this thing going?
Yes. By all means. Random is probably the only way we're getting out of this mess.
That's all we've been doing.
Well, in current affairs, I recently did a charity live stream. That was cool. Want to hear about that?
Yes.
Yeah.
This Saturday, actually every single month at the beginning of the month, I try to do a charity live stream, and we raised $10,000 for Living Beyond Breast Cancer in just under 6 hours, I believe. So we did
nice.
Pretty darn good.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
That's my goal. He only kept 80% of it for internal expenditures.
Yeah, you know, fees, transactions.
The breast examination.
Yes, exactly. I had people send me, you know, pictures just as support, you know, to keep me motivated right. and going on.
It's like,
yeah.
Ladies, snap. I'm ready.
Someone said, Mark, you should take your shirt off because you're supporting breast cancer.
They always ask me to take my shirt off.
I don't know why. I mean,
there are pictures of me shirtless on the internet somewhere. I don't know.
You should not say that here.
What?
It's already, people already know about it.
I didn't know about this. Like,
no,
yeah.
You want me
tell
to
us
now
a story.
We're all curious Hang as on. To what your shirtless.
I got my 8x10 modeling photo here. Let me just pull it out.
Oh, shut up.
I don't.
Jesus Christ.
I'm just
we're about
kidding.
To fight.
Just kidding.
We're about to have an internet feud. The
just
first.
Kidding. just can't hear me. All my muscles.
Yeah, no, I have like the exact same problem. Or like sometimes my muscles are just like they get in the way of my
I know.
Of my like picking up items or
they're
you know.
Just too huge, you can't reach your face sometimes. Oh man, it's horrible.
I know, it's just it gets so annoying. I'm like, come on.
Yeah, I know. It's just oh anyway.
And then I mean the modeling photos on the weekend, I mean mm-hmm. they can get yeah. tiring too, but I mean it pays well.
the photo shoots, the after photo shoot parties with all the models, and they're like, they just jump all over you. They rip your clothes off. I've lost so many wardrobes from women just ripping my clothes off. It's really unfortunate.
I know that feel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Bro moment.
You guys are one steamy locker room away from a sex scene. I swear to God.
Anyway, so let's talk about StarCraft 2, because that just came out.
Mm.
So, Jesse, you said you've been playing StarCraft 2. What do you think of it?
I love it. I like the game. I, you know, I'm not a big, like, I need to know every possible combination. What I do think is funny.
I thought that was you.
No, I'm the guy who's, I need to find every achievement.
Oh.
And so that's different. Oh my God, so different. I don't even get it.
I don't get it.
But one thing I've learned is even though I consistently say you should not listen to comments on YouTube, I do, and it always gets me in trouble. Perfect example, in like Mission 4, I spawn queens, and everyone's like, Jesse, you need to use the inject, whatever the shit those little guys are, the larva, inject.
The queen.
Larva. No, but the queen has inject larva ability. Apparently, it's only in multiplayer, and everyone's spamming me for an entire day about how I'm doing it wrong, and how I suck, and I cannot possibly figure out what to do, and I need to have my queens there. Meanwhile, the ability isn't even on their hotbars, and they're like, you're doing it wrong! You are the worst player who ever played any games ever! You are awful! Once again, this is my angry internet person.
Angry fingers. They're jabbing me everywhere.
And I so in one of the maps, I literally am like, sure, I will try and do it your way.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that's what happened.
What about the actual story? Are you enjoying the story?
Story's good. I think that it's kind of sad that I can already predict things that happen in the story. Wait, Blizzard. Oh, Blizzard. You're wonderful, but sometimes you're very cliche.
Blizzard likes their cliches.
Yeah, they really do. They really do. I feel like recently they've been phoning it in. So I don't know. It's good. I mean, the gameplay's good. I love Kerrigan. I can't wait to kill her. It's going to be great.
Oh my God.
Remember
when we were in the car and we were like,
oh my God, yes. Okay. For people who aren't aware, Krendor and I hung out a few weeks back.
Mm-hmm.
And we were driving in the car, and we had a moment that we literally paused and said, write that down. That might be the best thing ever.
So,
and Krendor wrote it down. Krendor, please, what kind of fun do we get into when we are not being filmed?
Well, we were driving, and I was like, so, what do you think about StarCraft 2? And you were just like, you know, it's like a lot of people are going to be getting back into the game, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. And I was like, it's like people, they just need to get them to care again.
And we both looked at each other and go.
We both paused for like 2 seconds and looked at each other and were like, care again.
It was amazing in every way.
It was an amazing moment.
It was wonderful.
Like we just.
You missed it.
It was like we just bonded even as close as possible through like that. Bonding.
Think of all the bonding you could do in that bunk bed.
What are you talking about?
The bunk bed that I'm buying you, Jesse.
Oh, Clint's going to buy me a bunk bed.
It's going to be a housewarming present.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a little late, but...
Oh my God, I'm going to have to turn off chat. Mark, I love you, but your fans are the single most
I know. I'm sorry.
Holy shit. I cannot function. Yeah, chat's off. God bless you. Every comment's like, who would watch this guy? He's awful. I don't know.
Wait, hold on.
Maybe you should go check out my channel and find out why someone would watch me.
Maybe. The effervescent and famous Markiplier, do hereby endorse Jesse Cox as the second greatest YouTuber in the world.
You're just making it worse, pal. Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's just trying. It's like
I try to help. I can't control them at this point. I couldn't even control them back like a few months ago when I had like, or half a year ago when I had like 2,000 subscribers. I couldn't control them. They're completely insane and out of my hands.
They're a mind of their own.
Mm-hmm.
I get the weirdest emails. You guys don't even understand.
Do tell.
Do tell. Well, let me try to find one. Give me a few minutes.
Oh, Jesus.
I'll read it online.
So has anyone else played StarCraft? The new one?
I just started it.
I mean, I looked into it, but...
Mark, what do you think?
Well, I mean, obviously, like I said before, I'm not the biggest StarCraft fan in the world, and it's okay to me. I love StarCraft. I want it to like it, but I can't get into it like everyone else does in the multiplayer. What? Story. Yeah, the story is fine. I mean, it's not great, like you said, but it's okay. I like just playing single player. I don't like competitive multiplayer games. That's not really for me. I like cooperative. That's why I like Killing Floor so much, because it's only cooperative. And, like, I never like PvP in World of Warcraft. I never like climbing the ladder in StarCraft. But it's fun from what I've seen so far. And I played like 2 hours of it.
Let's like, I am the complete opposite. I love competitive multiplayer, and I hate just like the single player things. I just don't like it.
It works for some people, but I mean, I don't know why. I played like shooters I can do. I used to be really, really, really competitive about Quake 3 Arena. I was like, that was my biggest one I've ever done, but it's just, I couldn't get into anything else. Even Battlefield, I can't get into that. Call of Duty, I just don't touch anyway, but I just don't like them for some reason.
I liked Battlefield 1942, and then I liked Battlefield 2 a little bit, and then I didn't really play the new Battlefield. I was like, it's whatever.
See, I don't even like League of Legends or any of the Dota games. The only I'm sorry.
I'm with you. Don't worry.
Okay. Like, I can't get into it. I mean, it's fun to play for a little bit, but I couldn't imagine doing that for days on end, just playing the same game over and over again. But that's just me. I don't mean to insult everyone, and I know there's people in chat that don't feel like I'm the Antichrist itself for not liking League of Legends.
But. Well, you do have to like have a certain like competitive nature to you, because it's like, the thing about playing it over and over again is because it's like, there's like different strategies, and you learn all the characters, like different play styles, and like there's so many characters that every game you're getting like new characters. And so it just like creates new strategies. So like one game you're playing against one set of characters and you have to play a certain way, and then the next game you're playing against a different set and you got to play a different way, and it's just like constantly changing on top of you playing a different character. So it's just like a combination of all those things. But then again, you have to also want to be in that competitive environment. Because like for single player games, I just get really bored. I don't know if it's like my ADD or if it's just my but I don't know, like Final Fantasy, I never liked Final Fantasy. I know that'll like also blow people's minds. Like, I tried playing it, I was just like, I don't care. I just want to like, I don't know.
Are you your first experience
with Final Fantasy though? Are we talking like cartridge days or PlayStation?
Like, I tried PlayStation ones, but I also tried a cartridge one, and I still didn't like it. I don't know. I just, there are very few games where like I'm like, the story's gonna get me in. Like, I just don't care enough. I'm just like, I want to like compete. It's just me.
Yeah,
I've played like RTS games forever, though. That's like what, like, I don't know. It's probably like what you grow up with too, in a way. It's like the first ever computer game I played was Age of Empires, and I was just like, this is awesome. And then I got into like Empire Earth, and that was all multiplayer. And then I just kept playing multiplayer games, and I just enjoyed it.
Well, I mean, for some people it works, but I couldn't imagine doing that. I get like, maybe it's just because I'm bad at it. I'm really not a good gamer. That's what I would say. I just have no skills at all. So maybe that's why I don't like it. Just because I get beaten into the ground every single time I log in.
I mean, that probably would make it not fun.
Anyway,
SimCity.
Oh yeah.
Why would you assume that?
Well, I am assuming that Mark is playing SimCity as well.
Tropico 4, not SimCity.
Why not SimCity? It's 10 years in the making. You're missing out on opportunity.
Mark's way too hip for us.
What? No SimCity?
Tropico has a bit big bearded dude on the front. He's a badass. I think
we're
it's Fidel Castro, really.
For Mark.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I'm kind of taking a moral stance on the whole SimCity deal, but I don't want to inject my feelings about the game and where it's been taken. But I don't want to talk about that.
Pause a minute. This would be the place to do
this.
That.
Is I'm the really place to talk right about now. It. In fact, I'm going to force you to talk about it.
Talk about. Okay. All right. Well, I mean, it's like I appreciate game developers, and I have nothing against Maxis itself, but I just have this sort of feeling that SimCity has always been a single-player game, and the fact that it's always online just irks me. It could be the greatest game in the world, and I still wouldn't want to play it because I feel like they're going. I see down the road this roadmap of DLC that they have, just like they did for The Sims 3. They have this roadmap of expansion packs and stuff like that, and I could see myself really liking SimCity for what it is, but at the same time. Well, I mean, I don't have anything. I'm not going to say anything about EA, so I'm looking at chat right now. I'm not going to say anything about EA or Max's business practice. It's just this particular choice that I cannot support. And if I ignore what I say and I vote with my wallet and I actually buy the game, then I've kind of thrown what my beliefs out of the window. And I feel strongly enough that this shouldn't be a business decision that goes on in the future of gaming. I feel like it's detrimental. I think I watched Total Biscuit's big video about pre-ordering and stuff like that, and I believe a lot of the same deals with that, and it's just I can't get behind that, so I just choose for this particular game to stand aside, and I will let it go, and I'll play Tropico 4 instead.
Well, it's like the same thing that happened with Diablo 3. Like, mm-hmm. They're not the only company to be doing that. They obviously have reasoning behind it, so there must be a positive reason for them that outweighs
everybody.
The other factors, but it's like the problem is like exactly what happened with their launch day is that when you put it online, it's going to get overloaded, like the servers, because there's so many people wanting to play it. And then on top of that, you have to, if people just want to play single player, they can't because they have to go online as well. So all the people that don't want to go online are going online. So you're just like, if you're not ready for that, it's just like,
mm-hmm. They're never ready for it.
When I first got onto SimCity, which I bought it early in the morning and went out, ran some errands, it was done downloading. I installed the game and I had no idea that it was all online. So the first thing that I noticed was that the plots are a whole lot smaller than, for instance, in SimCity 2004, you could build these mega cities and still have them all interconnected, and switching between the cities took seconds. It wasn't a big deal. And now in the new one, it's since everything is hosted online, it's like, oh, I want to switch to my other city. And you click on it, and then it loads, and it loads, and then it crashes the game, and you shut it off, and then you get in the queue, and you wait a half an hour, and all you wanted to do was to buy some freaking oil.
Yep.
And I think that's going to get fixed. But and also one thing that I did this week to kind of see whether the new SimCity was going to have a long-term appeal is I put together a 16-player co-op with one of the big maps.
Of SimCity?
Yeah, and I invited a bunch of the viewers to come and play with me, and it actually was really fun because everybody was building their own city, and I was mining oil, and then people were buying my power. And it allowed us to progress farther and faster than if you try to do it all yourself. And I would say it's a lot more fun to play with people you know rather than, you know, some random people join, you know, and screw everything up. Because I noticed you can go to somebody else's city that's in your map and you can plop down stuff. So, like, for instance, you can't go to with a bulldozer and bulldoze things. However, you can take the biggest park and go over to somebody else's city and just smack a park down right into their downtown area for no reason. Just and it deletes all their buildings.
That doesn't seem good.
I kind of went on a park rampage. I was like, you're going to have a park here and a park.
And then if they get angry, you're just like, you know what? You're not going to be angry anymore because I'm going to build a park over your house.
Yeah. Yes, indeed. Indeed. And I one thing that irritates me is every time I go to that town hall or city hall, those freaking hippie bastards won't shut up about something. They're always like, we want more residential. We want more industrial. We want another fire truck. Come on, guys. And then you give them what they want. And what do we get? More people yelling about more crap that I don't care about.
Exactly.
I want to be able to, like, assassinate individual Sims as they're walking down the street.
Just,
you know?
Just tear down their houses.
I do. Like, if they build a trailer park next to my mayor's house, that's an insult to me, you know? You see, like, you put in all this nice place, and then next thing you know, there's a freaking trailer there. It looks like somebody from Kentucky just up and plopped a trailer next to your mayor.
Hey, what do they have from to be Ohio, from... right next to Kentucky? I gotta protest about that last statement.
Hold on, where do you live in Ohio?
Cincinnati, right on the border.
Well, you're familiar with the Kentucky style living.
Hey, there.
Yeah, I grew up in Dayton, so don't worry, we are very close to each other.
Oh, you did.
Yeah. Nerds.
Shut
whatever.
Yeah.
Kentucky is
you
the greatest place.
You topographical nerds with your maps and locations. Thanks.
We're talking. Actually, when I was down in Kentucky, and I was in Kentucky, like the haulers, where all the rednecks live. Yes, rednecks. Mm-hmm. And I brought illegal Danish to show their kids. And so here's all these people that, like, they don't even know what the internet is, and they're watching illegal Danish, and they're like, what is this? I don't understand it. And they thought they were just completely blown away by this movie made in a video game, and none of them know how to play video games. They did finally get a computer, though.
I think you might be generalizing there just a bit, but...
I'm not generalizing. I'm sharing my real-life experience.
I heard that everyone in Kentucky likes moonshine and basketball.
My parents live there. I can confirm that.
Yeah, that sounds about right, actually.
Don't forget.
They love it. Every time I go home, my dad's like, moonshine, son. He blows on the jug. That's what...
Which one of you here has never had moonshine?
I haven't.
I've never had
what?
You've never had moonshine?
You're acting like this is a normal thing.
No, why would I have moonshine? Who the hell?
Authentic methanol moonshine, or are we talking like...
I'm talking like you go down to Kentucky
moonshine.
And you go, hey, where can I get some shine? It's some moonshine, and you take a little swig after Granny does.
That's what you do. Hey, where can I get some shine?
Yeah, you're going to get some shine. Moonshine is, it will put you on your back.
Mm-hmm.
One sip of that stuff. Changes your life forever.
Forever.
Probably in a bad way. I mean, you might as well hit yourself into rehab after drinking it.
Seriously? Can you just go... Look, I'm not up on moonshining. Can you literally just go there and be like, yeah, give me some shine?
Yes.
Be like, sure thing, mister!
Look for the like, old guy who works at a coal mine, and he's got to have a long, scraggly beard.
Oh, my God.
And that guy can hook you up with moonshine. That's how it works.
I found an amazing video on it that I'm putting up.
Is it like the Duck Dynasty guys? Because I love
yes,
them.
Yes. Exactly.
I love the Duck Dynasty guys.
Oh, yes.
That's him. The old scraggly white beard.
It's him.
Is this real or is this a guy just...
This is a video I found on the internet that has a million views.
It must be real.
Oh,
it
gosh,
has to be real.
I'm molested by a deer.
He's feeding the deer moonshine.
Off his head?
It's like, you want some moonshine, buddy? Because I got that for you.
I got my moonshine!
In Kentucky...
Give it to this deer!
Holy, oh my God, a possum! He has a
all
possum!
Right. PGS field trip. We're going to Kentucky to buy some moonshine.
I'm giving a beer to this possum I am! Boy, I'm gonna give it to him, good I
am! In Kentucky, you don't have normal pets like cats and dogs. You have possums and deer.
Yeah. And then you eat them when they get boring.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Why not? You know, I shot a squirrel with a pellet rifle when I was a kid, and my neighbor called, and she was like, what are you going to do with that? And I was like, I don't know. I guess cut the tail off or something and make a hat out of it. She's like, no, you got to eat it. Bring that over here. So I brought my squirrel to my neighbor's house, And she skinned it, gutted it, boiled it, and we had ourselves some fried squirrel.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.
How did that taste?
It tasted like chicken, but not as tender.
No, are you sure?
I mean, you know, it's not a lot to a squirrel. Like, if the four of us were stranded on an island and we had a fried squirrel, none of us would be satisfied. I would say one squirrel per person.
But what if chicken actually tastes like squirrel and everything just tastes like squirrel?
I think that would make the world a better place.
It would.
Well, you boil the squirrel first, then you
fry. Oh.
All right. I was about to say, did someone ask that in chat? Because I feel like that was something that I needed an answer on. You're like, so yeah, first we boiled it, and then you're like, fried squirrel. And I was like, no.
Can you go through the cooking process?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you want to recap?
No. How does this relate to video games? Okay. Do I have to be that guy? Do I have to be that person? Mark's fans are going to hate me even more. Why don't we just stick on topic, okay?
Rotto, I think it's time to move on here because there's nothing happening of relevance to games on the game station.
All right, Jesse, what do you think about your Awesome Knots character? What do you think?
He is amazing and overpowered. For those who are not aware, Awesome Knots, I just did a character, and he's wonderful, and you should all go play Awesome Knots. His name is Genji, he's the Pollen Prophet, worships the Space Butterfly, and he's amazing. And overpowered.
What's wrong with his face?
He's a worm!
Oh, okay, well, you didn't explain that first. I just thought there was something weird going on with his face. I'm not saying he's ugly. He's very beautiful. But
he's beautiful for the worm species that he's from.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Also, he has like a Kage little outfit. Is that how you say that?
I don't Kage?
I don't want the anime people yelling at me.
Kage! With that
thing.
What the hell is a Kage?
He has a Kage.
K-A-G-E?
So that's pretty cool. K-A-G-E. That's his outfit.
Association for Gifted Children? No, that's not right at all.
Ronimo Games gave me some Awesome Knots keys to give away, so I didn't have a chance to give them all away on Monday. So if anybody wants to try Jesse Cox's most amazing Awesome Knots character but hasn't picked up the game, tweet at @MindFlamePoundAwesomeKnots and I'll give these keys away.
You should definitely go play it. It's a wonderful game and it's stellar. I can't even. I'm honored to be a part of it. So yeah, that.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Have you seen? Oh, of course you haven't seen. I gotta find it real quick. But I've been talking with Ronimo about getting a character made for me, and Chibi Warmonger, one of my fans that does art. She does some for you too.
I don't know who that is.
Yes, you do.
Submit more fan art.
Okay, I have this. Let me see if I can get it on the screen. Mm-hmm. I don't know if this is going to show up in the right place or not, but I have this picture.
You're going to piss off the Awesome Knots fans because I've learned one thing. Magic does not go over well in that community. Apparently, if it can't be explained by technology, it is not a thing in the universe of Awesome Knots.
How do I just link this picture? Like, how do I just link? There it is. Okay, here's the picture. I'll link it in chat for you. But I think it looks awesome. Oh, my link got deleted before I even posted it.
I don't even.
Deleted link. Well, a beautiful deleted link. Anyway, you can see it right here. That's what Chibi Warmonger drew up. It's a, what it says is the Mage of Dark Arts and Poultry. So it'd be like a gnome character, probably with a lightsaber.
Time out. Here's what you need to do. If I know Ronimo, here's what they're gonna do. They're gonna make you a giant chicken. They'll make you a giant ass chicken, which would be amazing. Also, that is pretty great.
You can link it now, Clint Hackleman.
Okay, here's the picture. Still won't let me. Deleted link.
Really? I just updated it.
Maybe
it takes a little bit.
Yeah. Somebody else sent some pictures the other day with a giant robotic chicken. And I thought that might be a good idea, too. I would be just thrilled to death if I got to voice a character in Awesome Knots that was a giant chicken.
Mm-hmm. I've never even played Awesome Knots. I'm ashamed to say I haven't heard of it.
I feel bad for you because it's really fun, but it's right at the same alley of all those MOBA games, which earlier you said you do not play.
Oh, okay. That's probably why.
So I don't know. Yeah, that's pretty casual, though. So it's easy to get into, and you don't feel like, you know, it's not League of Legends. You know, it's not, 50 heroes that you have to learn, and the maps aren't complicated. So average match is probably 15 minutes. It's definitely.
I will give it a try. I will buy it sometime.
You should. I will give you a key, and you can get it.
Oh no! Give those away to your fans. I'm not that poor. I can afford it. How much is it?
I don't know.
Good guy, Mark.
Yeah. I'm always supporting with all the charity and whatnot, and I'm like, God, I'm so great. Mm-hmm. My Steam's not even loading. I can't find it. Okay, all right. I'll get it later. I'm not worried about it now. Good work.
Oh, no. I played Awesome Knots, and I thought it was all right. But if I didn't have League of Legends, then I would play it a lot. But I have League of Legends.
I like it just because you can start up a game and get into a game real fast. And it's not overly complex, so new people, you can, you know, like, for instance, I've had people join my games that have never played it before, and it only takes 3 or 4 games to really kind of play competitively. You don't have to be an expert. Like, MOBAs can be really intimidating, especially Dota 2. You get into that game, you've never played a MOBA before, you're going to freak out. You're going to be like, there's so much going on, what do I do? And next thing, you're in a turret.
Yep.
You're hiding in the bushes.
Is that your experience of Dota 2?
My experience of Dota 2 was, oh my gosh, why am I not playing League of Legends? Close. That was pretty much my... Because I love Dota. I mean, I played Dota for at least 6 or 7 years back in, you know, when it was made from the Warcraft 3 engine. Right. And I loved it. I thought it was great. And then when they came out with the new platform for it, I had already enjoyed a year of League of Legends, and I you know, it's really hard to sit there and compare the two, because League of Legends was, I guess, I like the way that League of Legends works better than Dota. I thought it was an upgrade. So then going back to the Dota after playing League of Legends just seemed kind of disappointing.
I think, you know, Dota's trying to sell itself on the we are more technical and you have to be able to do more things at once than we're the adult version of League of Legends. I think that's what they're going for. I don't know if that's going to work. TB loves it and he claims to be an adult, so who knows?
Yeah, Dota 2 is a great
Dota
game.
2. Love Dota 2.
I don't think there's anything wrong with Dota. I personally don't get into the whole, you know, you have to have expert skills to really benefit from the game. You have to really play it. You know, it's got to be like the game that you're playing from morning to night, 5 days a week, for months before you actually are competitive.
No, I agree with that. I think that's something that Mark touched on earlier, that the way he plays for fun. And he's like, look, I'm not the best, and I don't claim to be the best. That's exactly how I am when it comes to games. Perfect example, going back to StarCraft, I posted a video. I'm one of those idiots who reads comments, even though you should not. Mm-hmm. Note to every YouTuber, just don't. But so I'm sitting there and I read one that was basically, this is the worst gameplay I've ever seen. I'm like, pause. How is this the worst when I completed the mission, completed the achievements, had a blast doing it, and did it in a timely manner? What was bad about that? How was that bad? Just because I did it differently than how you would have done it, that's everything in Dota and League of Legends, especially League. If, like, you decide you want to have fun and you're not doing it right, your ass is just beat down. And I have no tolerance for that. Like, that's why I walk away from those things.
Mm-hmm. I just want to comment that I read most of my YouTube comments, and it's nothing but glowing admiration for me. I don't know what's going on with your channels.
Like, I mean, I get the same thing
everywhere. Yeah, I know.
I feel like we've learned that Mark is a liar today. A horrible
I'm not joking.
Liar.
I go to any one of my videos, I look through like, God, you're so great and handsome and strong. Oh, man, you're the best. And you don't get that? Never?
I get all of that, but it's usually from my mom, who is
she has six accounts so that she can post nice things.
Your mom's
You're doing
just
such
like
a good job, Mr. Cox.
Your mom's just like, Jesse, why aren't you injecting the larva? You should be using the queen.
I swear to God, at least 200,000 of my subs have to be my mom. I'm not even joking. The fact that I'll get messages from her, like, I figured she gave up on trying to figure out what I was doing a long time ago. She's like, look, just live your life, son. But she ever, like, even in Dead Space, like Dead Space 2, I'll get messages from my mom like, you should use the flamethrower more. Like, you watch this? All right, then. Thanks, Mom.
Just gotten her hooked.
She likes murder and me saying the F word a bunch. That's her thing. She's so proud.
Yeah. That's my son.
I know my mom is watching my broadcasts. Like, especially when I'm doing just completely stupid stuff, which is pretty much every day. So my mom is like, I watched your show today. And I'm like, what did I do? What did I do? Oh, my God.
What did then, you do?
Well, okay, like, for instance, my mom tuned in one day when I was on You Now, and I was getting people, like little kids, to make me toast. So they'd be on You Now, and I'd be like, make me toast! Now put Nutella on it! And my mom is watching this, and I'm thinking, this is not who you wanted me to be as a mom.
I just wanted you to be a doctor, and now you're telling little kids to make toast. On the internet.
There is something very funny about You Now and the fact that it's such a great platform for trolling. I can't, every once in a while I just get this urge to go on there and get people to make toast or draw mustaches on their faces.
Clint, can you explain really quickly, because I'm almost positive some people don't know what You Now is, because I think a lot of people would assume that's you just being stupid with YouTube. What is You Now? How does it work? For those
you
who
now,
are uninitiated.
You Now... Hold on, I need the proper hat.
What?
Okay, You Now... it's essentially a website to where anybody can broadcast live, and you get into a channel, and then you join a queue, and then you wait your turn, and you get... There's a thumbs up and a thumbs down. If you get thumbs up, you stay on. If you get thumbs down... The next person in the queue comes up and then you can get back in. So people get points and gain levels by entertaining people. The problem is most people are not good at entertaining. Like, you turn a camera on and they just sit there like rocks, like, I thought this would be easier. But it's just
Most of them, they'll like talk to their audience, be like, yo, Kua lover, I sure love Kua, and JK swag, yeah, definitely, Dino Shot LOL, yeah, me too, Mati Make, yeah, I am amazing and entertaining, yeah, I think you are too, Mati Make. Like, that's what they do, they just do that all day, and then the people in chat are like, I'm so special too!
I'm special.
We're all special.
I need to get on
they
this.
They do actually... pay some YouTubers to go and broadcast on You Now. Unfortunately, they won't pay me because I frequently abuse their system and they don't like that.
I feel like
weird.
I feel like Mark would do amazing on You Now.
I want to give this a try.
Yeah, Mark would do amazing on You Now. They'd just be like,
yeah,
oh my God.
Mark, you know, you should just quit YouTube altogether. Yeah. And usher in this new era of fine live broadcasting on You Now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm looking at right now. There's someone named Daniel Harris that is playing the piano. I don't know what is going on here.
Yeah, oh, you went there.
They're entertaining.
I'm here. Okay. I'm here right now. Oh, she's singing. Oh, okay. I don't know.
Your mistake was going there. I like how in your You Now hat, you looked like a wannabe trucker.
Yeah, I look like that with any ball cap. Because, I mean, it's like you just throw this hat on and any time I put a hat on, I look like a trucker. Mm-hmm. All I need is some more facial hair.
Exactly.
Did you specifically buy a hat big enough to fit around your headset, too?
No, they sent this to me. It was like, if you broadcast, they do these reward things. Mm-hmm. And if you get so many new followers, you get rewards. So I got a You Now poster somewhere and a hat. And they've given away iPads and Xboxes and stuff for the people that get the most followers. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, you have to broadcast a lot to get those rewards.
Jesse, didn't you play Euro Truck Simulator?
I did.
How was that?
If you want to see a video where I drive around listening to the Smokey and the Bandit theme song, that would be the one.
Sounds like the day I've always wanted.
It is. It's an amazing game for being a truck simulator.
I gotta look this up right now.
Yeah, how exactly do you play a truck simulator? I mean, is it just the
drive
actually from load to another truck?
I turn to the left.
I mean, there's got to be more to it than just turning the damn truck.
You okay. need
take missions to deliver yogurt, spelled yoghurt in Europe because of the Oxcast. Fact. And then it's true. H-U-R-T.
Now, yogurt. Is it on par with Farming Simulator?
No, not at all. Farming Simulator was much too detailed. This one's like, if you need to get gas, you pull up to a floating, like, gas symbol called petrol. Mm-hmm. And you drive up to it. I know, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you drive up to it, and then you, like, press E, and then you continue driving. That's it. There's a radio, and you can turn it on, but there's nothing on there.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
How much was this game?
$3. I got it on sale. Everyone was like, you need to play it. It's on sale. And I was like, done.
So it's like a true trucking experience.
Yes.
So flight simulators have, you know, the whole rigs you can get to make it more realistic. Does the truck simulator, like, have a gearbox that you can buy? Like a big old gearbox and like, truck dash? Because you're not going to get the real experience without the peripherals.
And gas station food.
You can look around inside the cabin of your truck. Mine had the worst interior I've ever seen in a car ever, which was perfect.
Did it have the air freshener of, like, the naked woman outline?
No, but I assume that was on the flaps on the back of my truck.
Yes.
Can you talk to other trucks on your CB radio?
Truck nuts.
Truck nuts.
No, you can't do jacket. I was talking to myself. I'm like, what? Hey there, good buddy, 10-4. This is Big J coming out of T-Town with a load, with a hot load on the big road. Just watch the video. I went online and found a big list of every term they used in Smokey and the Bandit, and I was going to recreate Smokey and the Bandit by doing, like, hey there, buddy, this is Big J coming out to you. And I get, like, bear is police officer, and I was like, I don't need any bear shooting me in the back. And everyone was like, gay! Like, what? And, yeah. So then in the end, I went to drive and listen to the radio. There was no radio song, so I played Smokey and the Bandit song, which is mm-hmm. amazing. East Down and Bound.
Have any of you guys played War Thunder? It's like World of Tanks, but with planes?
No.
Oh, man. You got to try it out, because it was somebody recommended that I try it out. And it's essentially a dogfighting game where you get to pick a plane and or a bomber. And there's, I think, 16 people on each side. And they're like PvP missions. You have the planes on one side have objectives like land on a landing strip or take off from a carrier. And then the dogfighting simulation is actually really good. And as you get experience and level up, and the more you level up, the more planes you have access to. But it's in beta, and it seems like it's going to be a pretty fun game. I'm a sucker for any type of airplane or helicopter simulators. So,
cool. So it's like a legit sim, like in the cockpit sim?
Yeah, you can switch views from either being inside the cockpit or behind your plane. And then you can also, like if it's a bomber, you get a view that looks down so that you can see where your bombs are going. And there's a ton of different planes. And you don't just get one plane. You can unlock more so that, for instance, you crash your plane and then you get another one. So then you're queued back up.
That's how it works in real life.
Yeah, as soon as your pilot dies, you just reincarnate inside of a new plane.
I never even played World of Tanks, though. Like, I don't even, like, what do you do in those games? Is that it? Like, you dogfight or, like, you tank fight or...
Yeah, I downloaded World of Tanks, and that's as far as I got.
I've always thought World of Tanks was one of those weird advertised games. I always see the banners for it, but I never click on them.
World of Tanks is actually, if you went to the, I wonder if it'll be at PAX East, but if you went to PAX Prime this last year, World of Tanks had like the single best booth there. I guess they were showing off World of Planes, which is their new one, and it was amazing. They really went all out. They like had a bunch of stuff set up so you could play and like tanks and shit. It was wonderful. I guess that would be the point if it's called
Tanks in the Game.
It's so much fun.
But like, so for War Thunder, is it like a battlefield type thing?
Yeah, like it has different maps or scenarios, and there's arcade style ones, and then there's kind of ones that are based off of real battles. So, for instance, one of the setups, it has three runways, A, B, and C. And the objective is to take control of as many runways as possible. To take control of the runway, you have to land on it, which landing is kind of hard. I mean, you end up crashing your plane if you don't know what you're doing. So you have all these planes that are shooting each other. Meanwhile, you're trying to land on this airstrip, and you don't actually have to stop. You just, you know, touch down. And then after so many seconds of being touched down, you take it over and then you try to protect it. And then other objectives, maybe they'll have a map where you have to use torpedoes to shoot down ships, or you have to bomb an area and take out all the ground artillery. So there's like co-op and then there's PvP type scenarios. Anyway, I thought it was going to be one of those games where you just, you know, play it and throw it away. And I ended up putting quite a few hours into it. I played it for 3 days straight, and I still have a desire to go back and play it, which means they must be doing something right.
Is it free?
Yeah, it's free to play right now, and I think it's going to be like the World of Tanks, where it will be free to play, and then they'll have a bunch of DLC, you know, that you decal your plane or get some sort of customizations or special planes you have to buy.
Okay. Yeah, I definitely got to give that a try because I'm, like I said before, I'm extremely bored 28 hours out of the day and I have no games to play. It's this weird thing when I started making game videos about games, when I'm in my off time, I don't have anything to do. My life is like extremely boring and I can't even get up the effort to play a video game. Like the only game that I really got into just recently was the Mass Effect DLC. Have any of you tried that?
Mm-mm. No,
it's absolutely incredible. No, I'm not joking because I actually talked with someone who works at BioWare in the cinematic department, and he told me that it was the one opportunity where the writers actually got to do whatever the hell they wanted, and it shows in the DLC because it's just a whole bunch of fan service and this hilarious writing. I can't even describe it, or else I'll be spoiling things. But I like spent I it was the last time in like 3 years that I stayed up all night playing a game just because I wanted to. So. It was just ridiculously fun for me, but I haven't been able to find a game like that in a long time. So,
if you want a game that you can dump endless hours into that's ridiculous and fun simulation, you have to get Kerbal Space Program.
Kerbal Space. Someone suggested that to me. What is it about?
It is a space simulator based on close to real physics. And you can build your own rocket ships and launch them into space, create space stations, and explore the Kerbal solar system.
Is this the one where someone launched a guitar into space?
Yeah, you could I built a ship called the Colossus, and it's the size of a football field. Mm-hmm. And we launched that into space, and it's like you can build practical ships, or you can just build ridiculous ships. And it's actually really fun because just building something and then getting it into space, it's hard. Like a lot of people will get the game and they build their own shuttle and they can't figure out how to get it into orbit.
What's it called?
It actually
again?
Takes some strategy.
Kerbal Space Program?
Kerbal Space Friday,
guys.
Jesse, all you're going to do is you're going to launch a rocket and it's going to crash into the ground. It's going to crash into the ground.
No, I'm going to get it right on my first try. Screw you, asshole. I'm going to make the best ship.
I'm going to email you the file for the Colossus, and then I want you to launch the Colossus into space.
No.
I built the ship. I built it so you know it's good. And it's gigantic.
It'll go to the moon. I can't say I know that.
Look, if you can get the Colossus into space, you are a man.
I can't promise you that I know that.
Look, just do it. just launch the Colossus into space.
Such
raise it up. The Colossus needs to be raised up to new heights.
That's Mind Flame's way of peer pressuring you into it. He's just like, come on, just do it. I know you want to.
Yeah.
I know you want to, Jesse.
Yeah.
I guess I am.
I have a video that you should put on the broadcast of me playing Kerbal Space Program. And there's this epic moment where, hold on, I'm linking this to you right now.
All right, you can link it and I will put it in the thing.
Here. This one is like 99% of the rocket exploded. And yet, somehow, I still got it launched into space.
Okay.
So I built this rocket, and I was like, everything possible went wrong, and somehow I still got the thing into space. It was amazing.
Like, what do you get for getting into space? Do you, like, a score?
I think they're going to do some sort of achievements, but right now, the main... There's two things that you can do. Once you get into space and you get into an orbit to where you're not going to crash back into the planet, you can build a space station. So you send up another ship and then you set rendezvous and then you have to dock them together, which is really, really hard. Or you can just go visit another planet. Like you can go to the moon and you can land on the moon. Like I went to Minmus, which is like the second moon in the Kerbal game. And it looks like a giant ice cream scoop. And so I took this big ship over there and landed it on the giant ice cream scoop. And that was my exploration for the day. So, yeah.
Is it multiplayer where you can have other people in there trying to launch space programs and you get involved in space? Or can you sabotage one by aiming your rocket to hit another guy's rocket?
I don't think there's any multiplayer right now.
That's a great idea. Then you could have, realistic rocket wars.
Yeah.
Realistic isn't the word you should be using. You know,
there is a mod community for it. They have their own built-in mod community, so people with the skills can create their own parts to assemble rockets with. So I would assume that the longer the game goes and, you know, gets closer to being finished, a lot of people are going to create third-party apparatuses to put on your rockets so that you can shoot lasers or, you know, have battles. You know, maybe get rid of space junk by blowing it up. I don't know. Maybe you could blow up planets.
I like how there's the little astronaut guy in the bottom right, like,
freaking out. He can get out. You can actually...
Why, when you guys get into space, is it suddenly super violent? Holy shit! Gene Roddenberry would be very disappointed in you. I'm just saying. Nerds, you're welcome.
I don't know who Gene Roddenberry is.
I don't either.
Gene Roddenberry.
Jesus. you guys might as well just die. Because, alright, judging by what I saw earlier from chat, I don't think Mark's fans are going to care. Krendor, as a friend of yours, I'm mad at you right now.
Oh,
so mad at you guys.
Creating Star Trek. I should probably know that. I didn't watch a single episode of Star Trek until recently, and I just started watching The Next Generation. And I like it, but I stopped watching it a while ago. So sorry about that. Sorry.
It's time for a break. Probably because it's time for a break. So we'll be back. And things and stuff and other things and Rado hip hip cheerio toe biscuit.
Meyer,
Minister
on B&H.
We're back.
Oh, we're back.
But now
I like to like surprise live, you back. All. Yep.
Oh, okay. Well, whoops.
We were doing, for those wondering what happens when you have four YouTubers in a chat together when nothing's happening, we were all like looking up equipment. That's how nerdy we are. We're like, hold on, where's this mic stand that you found? Let's look this up.
The Rode PSA 1 swivel. Oh my god, it's amazing.
Yeah, dude, if you think it's all glamour, it is not, my friends. We are sitting here nerding out over a mic stand. And like, holy shit, this will improve my performance by 33%.
It's proven. Studies have proven it.
Well, that Shure SM7B, that is an amazing looking microphone. That's the one that the Thriller video.
It's magical.
Koenig & Meyer music stand thing. I'm searching for it right now. I may just ignore everything that's going on so I can find this.
Mm-hmm. I found it on Z Sounds or whatever.
ZZ Sounds? That's a wonderful site as well.
ZZ Sounds? What?
But I can't find the exact one.
And now you know.
It'd be called a desk mic arm.
You're welcome, internet.
Yeah. Internet.
I've never even heard of Z Zounds, so I'm
okay. So you're in for a treat.
Welcome.
One place has it for sale for $159, and another has it for like $250.
You know what? Here's what we're gonna do, Clint. Just link it to me, and then
I'm linking.
We'll continue with
the podcast.
Just find
as expected.
That. Find that somewhere else.
Everything will go to order, and we shall talk about video games.
That's the same one that I saw for 53 right here.
Nobody cares. Okay, so we're going to be talking about video games now. Let us start out by talking about PlayStation 4.
Okay. Dear God.
All right. Okay. Well, there's a lot of things out about PlayStation 4 now that they announced it, and we can see that according to this thing, it says it will have a supercharged PC architecture, an x86 CPU, enhanced PC GPU, 8 GB of uniform memory, and a local storage hard drive.
Now, if you're really Total Biscuit, you would have something to say about all of those words which you just read.
Yes.
What would that be, Total Crendor?
That would be that I love PlanetSide 2. It's an amazing game. Yes.
What's the point of buying a PlayStation 4 when it's essentially just a PC now?
There is no point.
Yeah.
At least with the Wii U, it has something that's unique to video gaming, you know, whereas the PlayStation, it's like, yeah, you know, you can play on the handheld and you know, move it around and the gyros and the Wiimote and all that. At least the games have some sort of new gimmick to make gaming different.
Does the PlayStation 4
you know, even if they do add wands and stuff, they could just make
Have Move.
Oh, good. Good. I'm glad.
I don't know. First of all, I watched the entire PlayStation 4 press thing. Mm-hmm. And all I did the whole time was make fun of it because it was so awful. I mean, it was like, and here's the PC RAM that we're putting in it. And here's the PC ports. And here's the PC hard drive. This is not a PC. It is a PlayStation.
But think cost-wise and market-wise, like audience-wise, it's a lot of younger kids are going to play it. A lot of people can't afford a PC, and a lot of people don't want a PC.
The PlayStation 4 is probably going to cost as much as a PC.
Maybe, let's say it comes out for $499 at the end of the year. And a lot of people's minds, that $499 for a system that they'll have for 5 more years or whatever is is something that they're willing to spend money on rather than a computer that in 2 years will be pretty useless when it comes to games. Honestly, I mean, that's, I guess, devil's advocate. I don't understand it either, but I still own a PlayStation 3 and I have a PC that's way better than it. So who knows?
Is a 4 going to be backwards compatible with all the previous games?
No!
No?
In fact, get ready. Oh, you think that's bad. We actually had this conversation about pretty much everything that's happening with, you know, DRM and all that stuff. Like Steam, for example. Everyone loves Steam. But that's like a prime example of if Steam don't work, your game don't work.
Yeah.
And so Same thing with PlayStation now. PlayStation 4, funny story, is every single game you can re-download and rebuy. They're going to expand the titles that you can get. So they're going to have PlayStation 1, 2, 3, all that stuff. But you cannot like just stick in a CD and be good.
So you have to rebuy it in their store?
Yeah, on like their online store. That's what they said. Ugh. I don't know if that's going to change, but during the press conference, that's literally, they were like, you can get all the again if you want.
Manufacturers are doing that now. It's like you, if you've already bought the games for instance, you buy the game on the 3DS and then the Wii U comes out and now you have to buy the game again on the Wii U. You can't just, you know, they port them over.
Some people are saying
slowly taking away backward compatibility.
In chat, some people are saying that you can do PS3. So I assume that might be good, I guess. But if you have a backwards compatible PS3, you lose PS2 games. Because I guarantee they're not going to let you put PS2 games in your PS4.
They're going to do HD remix of them and try to get some more money off of it.
You know what? Sometimes I'm okay with that. I know people get all butthurt because, like, oh, I bought this game back in 2002 and I'm so mad. But sometimes an HD remake, I'm waiting for Ace Combat HD remakes. Just do it.
Or like, they could, like, awesome. Put them on PlayStation Network.
Yay.
Because then you just pay your subscription thing, and then you get a bunch of free games. And they'd probably do that.
Never mind. I read chat too early. Apparently now people are saying you can't.
Oh, okay. All right. Never mind.
I'll be right
back. Because I don't even have a PlayStation 3. I've been thinking about getting the God of War Ascension bundle just because I got to play God of War 3, and I've never played a God of War game before, and I really liked it. And the fact that you can get 6 games plus a PlayStation 3 for $350, it's kind of appealing, I guess. But I have an Xbox here. It's just a very, very expensive desk decoration at this point.
Yeah. No, I agree. Yeah, Xbox really has nothing. I mean, it has nothing for me at the moment that I find interesting. And even the online features, you're paying for nothing. At least with PlayStation Network, if you buy into that, you get free games.
Yeah.
Like every month they give you free stuff.
Yeah, with Xbox, it's like you can use Netflix and talk to your friends. It's like, oh, I can do that for free with everything else I own.
Like my computer. I could do that.
Yeah.
Actually, also, the most expensive thing that I bought recently was my Chromebook. And I don't know what you guys think about a Chromebook, but this thing is awesome.
I just bought, like, an iPad mini, so I mean...
Did you?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool. It's like an iPad and stuff.
Smaller.
Yeah, smaller.
I'm actively looking for something that I can show off. I got nothing.
I got my phone. When I'm charging my phone or it's somewhere else and I'm like, maybe I'm by my bed and I just want my iPad there. And my MacBook Air isn't anywhere to be found. I'm just saying. Where did Clint go?
I don't know. He went away to find something.
He said, I'm leaving.
I'm pretty sure that makes me somewhat afraid.
So, Yeah. PlayStation 4. That's me. They're going to have streaming. I guess they're going for that as well.
What about the new controller?
I love the new controller. I don't know what the hell the sensor is thing there, but it's wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know.
If I buy either one of the consoles, it's probably going to be a PlayStation just because I got an Xbox this generation. Why not branch out in the next one? I mean, unless there's a Let's Play that I really need to do of some exclusive game, I'm not going to be that excited about it.
Mm-hmm. That's the thing. Is like, how old are these consoles like that are out right now?
Six or 7 years old, yeah.
Yeah.
Because that's like, computer-wise, that's really old.
I remember Pentium 4. Mm.
Yeah, that's why games look the way they do comparatively on a PC to like a PlayStation 3 or whatever.
Yeah, and it holds back PC graphics because they have to limit it.
Yeah.
Which is the bad part.
That's now 25 minutes of PC elitism. You know what the world should do? Get enough money for a PC.
Tonight on 60 Minutes, we talk about why PCs are better.
That's going to be us. We'll have like our own 60 Minutes talking about PCs.
I'm all about that.
I went and talked to a guy who doesn't like PCs, and I'm going to ask him about it.
Just like... and we'll all be really
What do you guys think about
what
the Wii
I walked
U?
Into?
The Wii U is great for playing Mario.
Indeed.
Is it sad that that's the one thing that people get, like, the
like Wii U, I want there to be more games, but there aren't any.
Yeah, Wii U is has a lot of potential to be awesome. Everything about it seems like this will be great. But just like every other Nintendo system, there's just nothing to play on it. It's great, like, oh, this is cool, like, there's cool new features. But there's nothing ever to play on it, right? Like, that thing's amazing.
Yep.
Being able to play and not actually be near your TV is a wonderful addition.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even there was anything want, to play.
I don't want to even play games that you can't play on the handheld. Because that, to me, being able to play the game on the handheld unit is the best feature. Because it's like the wife comes home and wants to watch TV, no problem. You can keep playing. That's a great idea.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, they announced a bunch of games, but most of the games are games that you can get on any other system that will probably play better on the other systems. Let's be real honest. But with that said, they have a lot of like titles in the future. Bayonetta 2, I'm super excited for. Hopefully we'll get something about a Metroid or a Zelda or something at E3 this year. I look forward to that. But
Zelda'd be fun on it.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to the new Zelda for Wii U because I assume that it will be, you know, they'll be able to incorporate some sort of inventory management system on the handheld, and you'll be able to, like,
you think they'd have the balls to two-player it? Like, have one person play a different character, like Navi, like, hey, listen, you fly around and you give them stuff while you play on the control pad?
I hope so.
That'd be pretty cool.
Just because it sounds ridiculous and impractical.
Well, if there's someone playing Navi, then you at least have someone there that you can punch whenever they start to get annoying.
Mm-hmm.
All the buttons are just shouts. You have no. Hey! Hey! Hey!
Listen!
Yeah. Listen! Hey, listen! You have to do combos? Oh, shit. That's a game right there.
Hey, listen! Hey, listen!
Hey, hey,
there's
listen,
a game
listen, listen, hey.
For Super Nintendo called Test Drive, and it's a really, really old game. It was based off the original, which was for PC, that had horrible graphics and gameplay, but you could drive a Lamborghini, and that was awesome. But in the Super Nintendo version, they did something really quirky that I will never forget. It was two-player, but the second player could only do one thing, make the car jump. So, like, you're driving your Lamborghini down the road, right? And the guy sitting next to you has the second controller, and he only has one button, and it makes the car just, I'm way up in the air. Like, you can just jump over, like, five cars. And so, yeah, it's like, it makes me wonder what they were thinking when they added that kind of feature in. It's like, give this to your six-year-old brother. That way he can hit the jump button and feel like he's helping.
What a
that's
great
actually a we- yeah no that's a weird feature in a lot of Nintendo games. I know Final Fantasy VI is two player.
Whatever that
Why?
Means.
Final Fantasy VI is a two player game. Like, you can switch off in a battle between characters. Yes. I guess again for like your little brother. Like, you want to play? Like, sure. Now you get to play this guy, and I get to. I don't know. It seems entirely counterintuitive.
I'd imagine there would be just fights like, I'm driving the car. I want to drive the car. Jumping stupid.
There was the one. I don't remember what it was called, but one guy was the cop with the gun hanging out of the car, and the other guy drove the car, and you chase down bad guys. That's how it's done. So both are equally awesome. Like,
the only
you get to shoot.
The only co-op game that I really remember loving with my brother, because I grew up playing with my brother, like all through Super Nintendo, going into PlayStation and N64, was Rampage.
That game was awesome.
Big monsters destroying buildings, blowing up windows. We played that for like 98 levels in a row before our dad came down and told us to shut it off because we needed to go to school tomorrow. And we were yelling at him because it was freaking Friday, and he forgets what day of the week it is. It goes over and shuts off our thing. There's no save, so we lose all our progress. And we're like two levels from the last level. That's one of my worst memories showing up.
I don't get why they haven't made, like, a new Rampage
right?
style game.
Yeah.
Like, that's the best. It's like, you're just a giant monster destroying stuff.
Rampage, I had my first moment. Like, everyone had that moment in Metroid where they were like, oh my god, Samus is actually a woman. Mine was in Rampage. I loved Lizzie. Lizzie was my favorite character. Giant, like, T-Rex mother, just beating the crap out of everything. And then it's like, Lizzie's a woman. I was like, whoa! It blew my mind. I felt... And I kept playing because I love Lizzie, so...
Like, can we Kickstarter a new Rampage game? Because there's a bunch of, like, shitty games they're Kickstartering. Why don't we try to make something good?
Sell it for $5 on Steam? Just, you know, something real cheap.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Probably wouldn't take too much. It's... Get some random level generator and you're good to go.
Exactly. Oh, that makes me miss that game so much.
I do. I busted out my Super Nintendo a while ago just to play Earthbound again. I miss that game.
That's one thing about Wii, like the Wii systems, is the virtual consoles, so you can get those old games, and it's like in the old game format, so it's none of that BS like, we gotta change it so it fits better on a CD.
Is that how they talk?
That is.
Nintendo headquarters? Or no, Sony, that's, whatever.
That's the every other headquarters. That's okay. Every single one of them. Like, okay guys, what are kids gonna like?
I think they like when the games are online today, because all the kids are online.
Maybe if we charge the money to download other parts of the game, then maybe we'll make some more money. And they won't get mad about
that,
right?
They get stuff in return.
Yeah. Good idea, boss.
That
sounds like a plan.
That's the headquarters. And we're not getting any more games given to us.
I have no part in this at all. I'm just laughing very loudly.
Mark, you're part of the group. We are like the Power Rangers. We all come together to form one.
Oh, okay. Wait, we need a fifth. They always had a fifth there.
We're too good for a fifth.
Okay, all right then.
We're stronger than them.
We form a Megazord with just like a missing leg.
His name
hobbles into the battlefield.
Cripples or now with a crutch. It says a big crutch, but he can like pause and like pick it up and just be like bam and just hit people with it. Mm-hmm.
Send your angry letters to.
Anyway, let's look at the games coming out. Because there's a lot of them, even though most of them sound crazy, such as Monster High, the Skulltimate Roller Maze, that's for the 3DS, Darkstalkers Resurrection from Capcom. We have...
Love Darkstalkers.
I don't even
that's
know.
It. That's it. All I was going to say, Darkstalkers.
Never yeah. played it.
We got, for the iOS, we got Penguin vs. Yeti.
Oh.
And we got Patent Blaster. I take it to play that game you have to be like Apple or Sony. Yeah. They blast patents. It's like we have Sniper Ghost Warrior 2. That's coming out 2 days if you're looking forward to that. The 39 Steps. I don't know.
Sounds like an alcoholic, like anonymous program.
I need 39 steps. It's more than 12. Because I am...
I'm very thorough. I, you know, 39.
Oh, what is it? Yeah. Pet Zombies 3D?
Oh, shit. Looking that up right now.
All right. Pet Zombies 3D.
A must have.
Oh, the official trailer is right. We're watching this.
Oh, it's 3DS, though.
3DS, yeah.
3D.
It says 3D. It says 3D. Hold on. I'm linking you to the trailer. There's the trailer.
Right now. It was this Flash game where you were a doctor and you had a zombie that you had to experiment on. Is it like that?
I don't know. Okay, everybody quiet. We're going to watch the trailer now. All right. Here we go.
This is wonderful.
Here we go. Animated blood, crude humor, and fantasy violence. The following contains 2D video of a Nintendo 3DS game, 3D footage computer.
Neglected. Hungry. Alone. These are some of the shocking levels of abuse these creatures have had to endure.
Oh.
They didn't ask for this world. But since they can't leave it, won't you please lend a hand before they the rip hell? Yours off?
Here's your chance to raise the dead, literally, with Pet Zombies, the new game that gives man a new best friend. Play a variety of games with your zombie and earn Zombucks for cool new items and toys to treat or punish your zombies with. Customize your zombies' looks with new outfits and surroundings. Together, you'll form a bond that will extend far beyond
Zombucks.
The grave. Pet Zombies, available on the Nintendo 3DS, rated T for Teen. Sit, stay, be dead.
Please, open your heart. They like it that way.
Yeah.
I cannot tell a lie on this one.
That way.
Mm-hmm. That might be the best trailer I've ever seen.
That. It was amazing.
It might be.
Like, wow.
The only thing missing was that "In the Arms of the Angels," that song that plays over all those videos. Other than that, that was flawless. Oh. I don't know how gameplay wise. I mean, like, the look of the zombies, like, that interaction screen's kind of fun. Mm-hmm. But other than that, I don't know if, like, the game plays there, but it's still an amazing trailer.
It is. That. Wow. Like, people need to take note from them because they know how to make their trailers.
There's been a few great trailers like that recently. I know there was one that was, like, a live action one that was sort of a parody of. The Dollar Shave Club videos. Have you seen that on YouTube?
Oh, yeah,
amazing commercial. That. Look it up. It's hilarious. I don't know. They've been smarting up lately. They've been smarting.
They smarting up there.
Fuck it. I'm gonna keep drinking this Kickstart. Clearly, this is helping.
Clearly.
If you want a resource of those amazing infomercials, just go to Where Did the Soda Go on the subreddit. And it's just nonstop GIFs of all of those greatest infomercials where someone's got a platter of food and they just sit down and go, oh no! And then it dumps all over themselves and this big X comes up on the screen.
My favorite part of that is the I know exactly what you're talking about. The over-exaggeration, like, whoa! And then immediately it's like, do you ever have trouble carrying things back to your seat? Whoa!
Are you tired of dropping your spaghetti when you're trying to drain it?
That's exactly the sound effect, too.
No! Or it's like they're like, are you tired of not being able to cut up your fruit? And it's just like somebody being like...
Oh, no, my favorite one is bread. When they're like, do you ever have trouble cutting your bread? It's just a guy mashing a loaf. And then the other person, like, when they get the new knife, they're like, slice, like a normal person. And it's gonna, like, smash.
My personal favorite is when the wife puts the food on the table and the husband's just like, oh, this bitch. Oh, same meatloaf again and again. God.
You eat the meatloaf and you like it, Jared.
You know what I miss? I haven't seen a live infomercial in quite some time. I miss Ron Popeil and the set it and forget it rotisserie.
Oh,
I miss
him. Like where they're in front
of
an audience.
He was the best at 3 a.m. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Freshman year of college, drunk off your ass, watching Ron Popeil was mind-blowing. It's like, how does it know when to stop?
My personal favorite was the Magic Bullet one, where they're all in front of, like, a kitchen table. And they're just
and there's the one chef who's like, yeah, so I'm gonna make you some stuff. And there's the crowd, and they're like, wow, this really does taste like salsa. Like, what the fuck does it taste like?
Yeah, there's like all the different types of people, like, I'm in the mood for a smoothie. They're like, well, the Magic Bullet can do that for you. We're gonna cut up some fruit, and then it's like, put it in, and she's like, wow, this is going great. And some guy's like, I don't like smoothies, I like nachos. And they're like, well, we're gonna make you some nachos.
Oh my god, I need to find that on YouTube. That is a terrific commercial because they pretend like it's these people we just found on the street and now they're gonna come in and have food with us and they all have different tastes. They aren't willing to settle and they're like, oh man, if only someone would make me like a chocolate mousse. It's like, don't worry, I can do that. Here we go.
Oh wow, it tastes like it's straight from European ice cream shops.
That's my favorite part, is it's like this little tiny vibrator that cooks stuff for you. No, it chops. I'm sorry. Chops.
Mm-hmm. It chops, not vibrates.
It's a vibrator that chops.
Serves two purposes.
The single worst decision ever made by a company. It's a vibrator with knives in it. What's not to like?
Oh, what was that one? It was where he's like selling the book on how to make money on the internet. And he's just like, what are your secrets? And he's like, my secrets are all in this book that you can buy for $29.99.
Does anyone remember the guy who wore the question mark suit?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Oh.
It's a guy who wore a question mark suit who's like, I can tell you how to get lots of money from the federal government. Yeah. There are over 4,000 programs just sitting there, not giving anyone money, but I can tell you how to get it. And he was the most annoying person ever. You thought that was annoying. I barely did him justice.
Everybody. Yeah, and now he's gone, but they have, like, this other guy who's just like, I'm going to tell you about the programs where you can get money from the government because they don't want you to know.
Or at the Extends commercials with yes. The porn stars and Ron Jeremy, and they sit around on, like, an interview set, and they're like, have you ever had trouble with that part of the anatomy? Ron Jeremy's like, what do you mean? Which part? And they're like, you know, that part of the male anatomy. And from that moment on, every time they interview someone, like, I've always had trouble with that part of the male anatomy.
And it's always like,
Extends.
It's always like the most like scummy people on the street. They're just like, I've always had problems with that part of the male anatomy, but then I took Extends and it all got fixed. And then they ask like the woman, she's like, it's true. He has now grown in length down there.
Right? I was about to say, the men say that part of the male anatomy, the women go, you know, down there.
Penis.
No, I don't. Go on.
Like, why don't they just use the terms? Like, there are some scientific terms.
You'd expect at 4 a.m. they could get away with it. At 10 p.m. you can see, like, people bang it and ask because they shit on TV. 4 a.m. it's a little too close to morning to the kids.
I've always had a theory, though. It's not because it's censorship. It's because if they don't say specifically what it's for, then people can't sue them for not working on that specific part of the male anatomy because they never said penis. They didn't say it was going to make your penis bigger. They didn't say that.
That's
they
true. Didn't.
I like to imagine they were talking about the taint. They were like, look, you're going to have a giant floppy ass taint just hanging down there, waggling.
Jesse Cox, 2013.
Jesse Cox for Pope.
Jesse Cox is the new Pope, and that is his speech.
Long said to me, let thy taint grow to maximum proportions.
Mm-hmm. Taintus maximus unus ininus pluribus.
I expect these kinds of things from Clint, but not you.
Clint has checked out. He's like, F it. You guys are too immature for me.
I just can't take it anymore.
Hold on.
Errado. Now we're gonna get back on topic because it's gone way too off topic, and we're back on topic. So let's watch another trailer for a thing. This is going to be for a shitty game I like to call Angry Birds, who have now made a cartoon. Let us watch it.
Wait, there's an Angry Birds cartoon?
Yes.
Yay.
Just watch. Hold on. I'm gonna link it to you. Hold on. Here you go. I linked it. Okay. Let's all watch it now. This is exciting.
Wow.
Yep.
Mm.
opinions.
Where to begin?
Yes.
Money, 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 Angry Bird. Money, 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 money.
Money, 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 rocket everywhere. How much are they going to milk Angry Birds until it's gone?
It's going to be here for the next 25 years.
Really?
Yeah, just in
time.
Minimum.
You know what feeling I got? The exact same feeling when I saw that... I don't know that Star Wars, that new, I guess it got canceled, but that commercial, the trailer for the new Star Wars animated cartoon thingy that I think Seth Green made.
Seth Green?
Mm-hmm.
Huh.
The Clone Wars died. Thing?
Seth MacFarlane?
Not Seth MacFarlane. Who am I thinking of?
That would be a vulgar cartoon.
Robot Chicken Guy. What the hell is
no, that
name?
Is Seth Green. Okay, yeah, that's Seth Green. Yeah, Seth Green.
Yeah, not. It's not Robot Chicken. It's not Clone Wars. It's something else entirely that was like a Star Wars, like, blooper, like Star Detours. That's it. Thank you, chat. Star Detours was, like, unbearably bad looking. And so that's the, like, deep down in my soul, that's the kind of, if you want to see awful, go watch what we just saw and Star Detours back to back. And it's on the exact same level of just like, why would this be made? And the only answer is because they're just milking a franchise. There's no other explanation because it's not funny and it's not cute. And Robot Chicken was fine. The Star Wars stuff you did there was great. The Star Wars stuff you did in Family Guy was wonderful, Seth MacFarlane. But they got together like, let's make something called Star Detours, which is shit. And that's what the Angry Birds thing is. Hmm. Garbage. And I ain't having it.
You have no garbage tolerance.
None.
It's your policy. It's the Jesse Cox policy. It's like, I shall not accept garbage. I shall recycle.
That's it. That's my policy.
That's it.
Recycle, kids. It helps the environment.
I need the hat again.
All right. Well, let's take another break then, since we've now gotten tired and run out of ideas to be entertaining, if we were even entertaining in the first place. So, let's take a break. We'll be back. This is the TGS podcast without myself. I mean, I'm here, but without people that are entertaining, except for Mark. Because Mark is Mark.
He's pretty wonderful.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I know. I am.
He's going to do it.
I knew he was going to do it.
You knew it.
I'm not back.
Well, nobody cares.
Okay. Well, maybe Leo will get on there for me.
Mm.
Okay, that's good. Hi, we're back.
Yes.
And that's a thing. So I put the links to the songs and all the thing, because, listen, Genie, screw you. The music is not hilarious. It is amazing. Screw you. Anyway, let's talk about things. So this is the point of the show. Hold on.
This is the point of the show. Where we can do host topics. So,
yay.
Since nobody ever brings one, I'm going to force you to make them up on the spot. Clint, you will be the first to go. Go.
All right, what would you like me to make up?
You
that's,
can
that's
make
not
up.
The point, Clint.
Just
oh, I'm so
something
sorry.
Something relative to gaming.
Something relative to gaming. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A topic that we can all enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. You know, gaming's just not that interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. I think we should do something else.
Okay.
Want to talk about sports?
Yeah. I like sports. Yeah, that's what our demographic wants.
Yeah. I actually don't watch any, so I'll be the expert in this department.
Yeah, okay. You're all right. Self-proclaimed expert, Mark.
I was watching the game recently, and it was real exciting when they scored a goal unit down the infield. There was two teams. I think there was a third, but I wasn't sure. And they were There's basketball happening, right? March Madness? Yeah. Is that a thing? That's a thing, right?
March is mad.
Yeah, and is that college or the NBA? I don't know.
It's college.
College? Okay. I think Indiana was supposed to be a good one. They were playing, right, Clint?
Of course. Of course. They always are.
Mm-hmm.
And has football started yet?
No. They're going to have the draft soon.
Oh, what's the draft?
The draft is where they draft college players to NFL teams.
Oh, that sounds important.
And it is. It's very important.
And that's all I got.
That was wonderful.
Thank you. I know.
Good work. Good work.
Okay. So, hold on.
Oh, bloody awful. All right. So... Jesse, can you save us? I know I don't say that very often, but...
Come on, Jesse! The world awaits.
Mm-hmm.
First, I think I would, before we do anything, can we finally figure out what you have been writing on your whiteboard back there, Clint?
Yeah.
It is filled with stuff, and I can't read any of it. And well, I feel like we're missing an opportunity for comedy.
It does say Cox Rocks on it.
That's mostly what I wanted to know. All right.
People were sending messages on my widget, and I was reading them and then writing those people's names. They're fans from my live broadcast. They're shameless promotions for Hamp and Zymusius and Andy. And,
all right.
Can you just move the camera up to the whiteboard?
Yeah. My batteries have run out on my headset.
Oh. There we go. There you go. Just bring it on up there. This is like we're back in school.
X and Menusis.
Andy?
Dinosaurs? Dinos.
Are you just making up words?
Damn.
Okay.
I would like to say, don't read the first two lines by themselves. Or together, sorry. You know what I mean.
I did not catch on to that.
Anyway, so my actual thing today, since we have a guy who is a fan of the scary games, Clint, he's very quiet about it. So a lot of people lately have been complaining about two things. One, big games like Dead Space, things like that, big franchise games have lost all their scare factor and are basically now monster shooters. Mm-hmm. And indie scary games are essentially the exact same thing over and over and over again, where you are you're running from a monster who's like, "Girl, I'm going to get you." And that's it. You just run from a monster. And so, since I have you here, I want to know what you thought about that, because I mean, I have my own opinions. Like, for Dead Space, for example, I'm like, it's his story arc. At the first one, he's scared, but the last one, he's like, let's kill some bitches. So, that's my explanation, but I know it goes to all games, like Resident Evil, things like that. And so let's talk about that when it comes to franchise and then indie games.
Okay, I've always been of the opinion that there is a certain factor where the story has to take precedent over everything else. You like you said, in Dead Space, obviously the natural progression was that Isaac was going to get better at killing these monsters. They were going to become less of a threat unless they just got bigger and bigger and bigger. But at the same time, it doesn't have to be that way, because I'm going to take an example from Half-Life 2. Everyone remembers Ravenholm. Everyone who's played Half-Life 2 remembers Ravenholm. They remember it as this suddenly, like, it was hinted at, no one goes to Ravenholm. And when you go into there, it didn't matter what guns you have. That place was scary. Like, it was sudden shift, like, superpowered Gordon Freeman goes in there. I still have chills from back when I first played that. But at the same time, you can have that action, you can have the big scary game, but you don't have to dumb it down for the masses. I think that's what I read recently, that Valve wants to, in the next half, like whenever it comes out, they want to pump up scariness in games and get that more. But it is lost. It is lost a lot because, like you said, it's repetitive in indie games. Like, everything wants to copy Slender. Everyone wants to collect 8 or 9 of these things and then run to the exit. It's hard to see some creativity, but at the same time, it's hard to find out what's scary. You know, I don't think there's anybody out there that could really nail down what scares everybody. You know, it's a mixture of atmosphere. It's a mixture of helplessness. It's a mixture of running. Some people find Dead Space scary. Some people find Dead Space 3 scary. And it's just interesting. So I kind of am rambling now. What was the question I was supposed to answer here?
No. What about indie games? I know you play a lot of indie scary games. And I saw that you nodded when I mentioned that they're basically progressively becoming the same sort of trope over and over again. I mean, how do you feel about that?
People want to copy on the same recipe. That's a big thing in gaming recently. That's kind of a negative trend. People copy what is successful. Like, at first, when Amnesia came out, you know, people would copy that recipe in the horror games of that era. And then horror games got a bit bigger. Like, it kind of grew some popularity. Like, people found Amnesia to be unbelievably scary when it came out. And so people had to try to emulate that, to try to make their game scary, to appeal. Like, that's where the money was, that's where they went. But they lose creativity, so you've got to find, like, these pivotal moments in horror games where you find something. Like, when Slender first came out, there wasn't really that game mechanic. Like, it's what Amnesia was. In complete helplessness, they took it and they adapted it to something else. And this guy made something in a few days and it became something big. But at the same time, like, I don't know where I'm going with this, but there just isn't enough creativity in it. Like, people can't find that one thing that catches on that scares everybody.
Do you think it's because once you tap into that thing once, it's sort of gone? Like, a great example is...
It's like MMOs.
That's exactly right. Mm-hmm. Once you find that perfect MMO, everyone copies it, but then no one tries to branch out and discover new things. And it might actually be very hard to do that. And it might be because most scares are victims of its successful scare. So, like, mm-hmm. if it gets you once, it's one of those, like, fool me once, shame on you kind of things.
Yeah.
And Amnesia is, because it's such a long game, it's the perfect example of that, where early on you don't see monsters, and the ones you do see aren't even real at the beginning, and so you're freaked out. And I remember when I first played that, I had 3 girls giggling over my shoulder, just making fun of me because I was scared to death. Mm-hmm. And by the time I'm halfway through the game, it wasn't scary anymore for me. I was like, I'm going to throw rocks at this monster's face. I don't care. Because at that point, once you figured out what was what, the scare wasn't there. It was about successfully beating it without dying. Mm-hmm. And that, the scare was like, I just don't want to die because that's a pain in the ass. I got to redo the whole damn thing.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
The same thing, I think, works with Slender, which is, you know, you can make all the scary videos you want of like, oh, I'm scared of Slender. But at some point, it becomes less about the scare and more about really being pissed off. This asshole won't let you collect 8 notes. Mm-hmm. Like, just let me pick up the notes, dick. And he's like, no, I'm behind you. Right? And so... And I think that might be a problem, that once the scare's gone, and then when they try to ramp it up, they lose that scare factor, because it's all psychological. I don't know what you feel about scary games, but the best ones are the ones that don't show you the monster all the time.
Yeah, exactly. It makes you in your head, you're creating more monsters. Zero punctuation. Yahtzee's review of Amnesia was fantastic. I love that because he explained perfectly how Dead Space isn't your scary because it's a whole orchestra of violins like screaming at you right behind your ear as this monster slowly walks towards you and you have this gigantic gun that could destroy him in one blast. Like, that's not scary, but when your mind actually creates a monster, that's the scariest. So I completely agree with every way. And at the end of Amnesia, I was doing the same thing. I was throwing rocks and chairs and I was just jumping around. It wasn't as scary as it was. And because I played so many Amnesia custom stories, it becomes progressively less scary for me.
I've been talking about this anecdote for a good week and a half now. So I apologize if you've heard me talk about it before to anyone watching or in chat. But I'm really obsessed with Peng in Dead Space. Like, I think that creation is amazing. I don't know what it is. You know, it's one of those things like, why is that there? Why does that exist? Who is that? And as a lore nerd, I have to know, like, everything. And so I was finally sent a video that was the creators of Dead Space 2, when that came out, doing a panel convention or some type of industry convention panel, and they were talking about the game and how they created it and all the different parts of the game. But one thing they talked about was Pang. And they said Pang was created because they went to a convention panel. Yes, yes, Clint Hackelman.
Oh, I was just waving.
All right. Anyway, I thought you knew this and were going to help me tell the story.
No. I can't help you here.
All right. So anyway, they said that they went to a very similar convention and saw a very similar panel a few years before when they first made Dead Space 1. And the idea was that the guy giving the presentation said, look, when you make a game, one of the major things you have to do is create something that is completely and totally out of place or doesn't make any sense. It'll make the gamer lose their shit, and they will focus on that particular thing. And they were like, oh my god, okay, so if we're gonna make a scary game, let's make Pang, which is totally, it's like this like hot girl, like there's always Pang, and everyone's just like, what is that, right? And the example the guy gave, which, I mean, you know, Pang's what they use for Dead Space, but the example the guy gave at the time was, if you're making a game, let's say it's a military game, and there are tanks like driving at the screen, or there's a cutscene, right? Have one tank just drive off screen. For the entire level, everyone will be obsessed with where that tank went because they don't see it. They don't know where it went. It's a thing that isn't there, yet it's always on someone's mind. And I think that relates perfectly to scary games where if you don't see it but you know it's actively there, that's the scariest type of game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree completely. So,
and then you need a game that's like you said, you don't want it to be... like I get it now. I'm just gonna beat it. You want it to like constantly be like scaring you. Mm-hmm. So otherwise, it's like it becomes just another like, what do you call it? Like a puzzle game, pretty much. It's not even a scary game at that point.
But are there any games like that? I mean, what's the one where you're on the island? Tiramisma, something Misma.
Miasma,
is that what it is? The one that's on Steam where you're on an island and you're just like creating stuff and living.
Miasmata, that's what it's called.
Yeah, have you played that?
I have not.
Everyone keeps telling me that I should check that out. Basically, you're being stalked by something the entire time that doesn't even reveal itself to like the very end. Which I'm like, that is a great premise, but I don't know how engaging that would be. Because after a while, it would end up being like Clint, where he just zones out and starts making a mustache.
You're just like, listen, I don't really care about Miasmata anymore. He can kill me, whatever.
Have you ever played Fatal Frame, Mark?
No, I've been recommended. That's on the Wii, isn't it?
Oh my god. I don't know if it's on the Wii. It might be. I think Fatal Frame 2 is on. Fatal Frame 2 sucks. Find Fatal Frame. I think it was old school PlayStation. Uh-huh. That game, you might as well just give up on caring about your pants because they will be shat in. That's the one game of horror games that I refuse to play ever again. Like, I can play other games because I know, like, what happens when it, you know, once you figure out where the scares are, you can just push through it. Mm-hmm. This game is basically like, hey, you're a little Japanese schoolgirl with a camera and you can only see and kill ghosts when you put the camera in front of your face. So the entire time you're walking around, shit's like right here, and you're like, I wonder what, oh my god! Like, that's it. It's horrible. It is an awful game. Those people who made that are bad people. Yeah. You need to do like a full body, just camera on your whole body, you playing it on whatever, and a camera on the TV. Camera multi-screen that shit and enjoy. You need a poop cam. You need a giant poop cam.
The new thing.
Just do it from your toilet so we can hear the plops.
These are all fantastic ideas I'm going to incorporate in my next video. I'm moving soon, so I'll set up my whole game station in my bathroom. Have everything there. That way I never have to move.
We're creating an amazing horror game right now. You got tanks driving away. You got schoolgirls holding cameras that can only see ghosts when you hold it up to them.
Mm-hmm.
What else can we add? How about...
More cams.
Yeah. You need notes all over the walls that tell you things.
Yeah.
You have to collect the notes, and it's just like, I'm watching you right now.
Mm-hmm. That's scary. That's scary right there. Clint's mustache is kind of scary.
We could throw talk that about your mustache. I know you want to.
Well, I was going to go for something a little more reserved, and it got kind of out of control over here, and now I'm trying to create some sort of symmetry between the two sides, which appear to be fighting. Because, like, hey, right Mark, over, like,
Mark, can you just move your hand really quick, like, off to the side? Like, yeah, okay, and then just start moving your mouth. Just don't talk, just start moving your mouth. Hello there, everybody! It's me! I'm gonna welcome you all to my Fungeon! Okie dokie!
The Fungeon.
Wah, perfect.
Okay, all right, we're all done there.
The Fungeon is what our horror game will be called.
The Fungeon.
The Fungeon. Are you looking to get scared? Come on down to the Fungeon. Sounds like it could be a food. Like, I got some Fungeons at the store the other day. They're pretty good.
We should kickstart this right now. We could get all these people donating. We get a great game going. Do any of you have any game making skills?
No.
Much better about this conversation now than I did before. Sorry.
Hashtag Fungeon 2013.
Hashtag, that's it. That's this podcast.
It is.
Hashtag Fungeon.
I'll tweet Fungeon. That. I'll do that.
Breaking news. The Pope has been elected.
He's from Argentina.
Bergoglio.
Bergoglio?
Bergoglio of Argentina.
I want to know what that bodes for the prophecy.
The prophecy?
I'm not joking. There's a prophecy that says this is the last pope if he is somehow connected with the word Peter. Either he's from someplace Peter, or he named himself Peter, or something about Peter. Trust me. In which case, shit's about to go down. Or it's bullshit. One of the two. It could be totally real or total bullshit. It's one of the two.
His name is Bergoglio.
That's Bergoglio?
Bergoglio.
Who names their kid Bergoglio?
That is very offensive.
Some guy from Argentina.
Is that his Pope name or is that his real name?
I think that, I don't know. He may have just chosen that as his Pope name.
Bergoglio.
Well, his Pope name is Francis. Okay. Oh, Francis! Like, Franny! Team Franny. Hashtag Team Franny.
It's
everyone, if you're not already, here's your mission. Dude, Mark, you need to do this.
Okay.
Get on Netflix and look up A Talking Cat.
It is
best
amazing.
Best movie ever.
You will not be disappointed.
A Talking Cat. Okay.
Question mark, exclamation, question mark.
Yep.
It is the best movie ever. And there's a character named Franny in there, and I want to call Pope Francis Franny. Franny.
Hashtag Pope Franny.
Hashtag Team Pope Franny.
Team Pope Franny.
Team Pope Franny.
Hashtag Team Pope Franny. Done. Yeah. Got it. Oh, and Jesse, Sarah sent you a message. I wrote it in chat there.
My.
All right.
Hello.
What are we? All right. This seems like we're getting to the end.
It does. It does seem like that. But we can... What is... Is Flint running another live stream while this live stream is going on?
It is possible.
That one's happening here?
It wouldn't surprise me.
We are being double streamed.
It's like Streamception, man.
I don't even know what to say.
It's time for the hat.
Since this thing has gone to shit, granted, it's been shit the entire time.
So we're not talking about bronies. Maybe next.
All right, let's wrap it up. What are we doing with our channels and whatever? All right, let's start with Clint. Clint, what are you doing this week? Where can we find you?
Well, I'm going to be broadcasting at twitch.tv/mindflame every day this week and every day next week for the foreseeable future. That's what I do. But the games that I'm going to be playing, I'm going to do Awesome Knots on Friday with my fans. And I'm also probably going to get back into War Thunder. Maybe if Jesse will join me, we'll do our daily rep grinds in World of Warcraft. And then I was thinking about building a new craft in Kerbal Space Program. And then there was one other game that we talked about at the beginning of the stream that I was thinking about trying out, that sim game that was $25 or whatever that I still can't remember the name of. Huh?
Tropico, where you play as... Fidel Castro?
I think he meant Sims Katy Perry edition.
Star Drive. Like,
Oh, Star Drive is the one that was on Kickstarter. I helped sponsor that. I feel good about that game.
I was thinking that I was going to try it, but I don't know. It seems pretty slow-paced, so... Anyway, yeah, I may upload some highlights to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/mindflame, but just follow me on Twitter, @mindflame on Twitter.
It's all mindflame.
Yeah, it's I'm easy to find. And I broadcast at 3 p.m. Eastern, Monday through Friday. Maybe Mark will join me. We'll play a game and play it terribly. Just awful.
I'm not that bad. I'll have some skill in there.
No. All right. Okay, it's enough promotion for you. Mark, where can we find you? What do you do? What are you making this week? What do you do? All that stuff.
You can find me on YouTube at, you can either search Markiplier or go straight to Markiplier Game. Either one will go there. I'm going to be playing an assortment of more indie horror games of strange names. Light Arrow, Containment, or SCP Containment Breach, My Little Pony version, Nyctophobia, Somnium, all these weird names. But yeah... And then I'm going to be trying to do other stuff, but I don't really know. I don't plan anything ahead for my channel, ever. That's
a good idea.
Yeah.
Don't plan.
Planning, silly.
Yeah.
You can find me on Twitter, Markiplier, Facebook, whatever.
It's all Markiplier.
Everything except Instagram. Can't stand that.
Instagram, more like Insta shit. All right. Well, Jesse, see you now. Where can we find you? What are you doing? Blah, blah, blah.
YouTube.com/Omochikata or /JesseCox. They both go to the same place. And this week, I am pounding out StarCraft. Should be done with the series by Friday. And then I am going to prepare for PAX. I will see you all there. I will be on several panels there. So if you want to stop by and watch me argue with some guys... about which are the best games of the year, or this very podcast panel with TB and Dodger whenever they decide that they're cool enough to come back and talk to me. And
no, you're talking about them right here.
And other than that, everything else on the channel is on hold until StarCraft's done. That's just the way it is. Also, injustice.dccomics.com, go there and just vote and have fun and watch the various DC superheroes beat the living shit out of each other. It is a very cool contest for a very cool game, and you should go and participate.
Brilliantly done.
Brilliant.
A+.
Thank you.
Grendel, what about you? Oh, well, this week I'm going to be making a new machinima. It's pretty great. I still make those, if you can believe that. And then let's play in WoW. I keep playing WoW. I'm leveling. I'm level 22 or 23 now on my hunter that I'm leveling. People are like, why are you reading the quests? Why don't you just loot everything and power level? I'm like, that's not the point. I do that. I've done that for like 8 years. I want to read stuff as I level and actually learn about the quests.
You silly man.
Yeah.
Reading.
And what else am I doing? I'm playing Scribblenaut some more. And I got my Blood Bowl stuff. I have to make an update on my team that is amazing. We continue to be amazing. And, do I do anything else? I don't think so.
There's one thing you do.
Oh, yeah, there is. There is this thing called Cox and Crendor, where Jess Cox and myself, Juan Crendor, do a podcast. And you can go listen to that on soundcloud.com/Cox, then the letter N, and then Crendor. And we also have a YouTube channel where you can go to youtube.com/Cox and Crendor, and there may be some amazing things coming to that channel in the near future.
Friday.
There may be some amazing things coming Friday to that channel. It will be magical and wonderful. Also, you can go to Rodeo Arcade and see my Lil Skittles t-shirts. They're amazing. You can buy one.
If you want a good t-shirt, one that won't make you when you're walking down the street, you should probably go get the Frankenstein Joe t-shirt on Rodeo Arcade. It's way better than whatever Crendor's made.
Mine is for memorabilia of the greatest player of Blood Bowl history.
God, I hope he dies. I want him to die so badly. Then I'll get that shirt. I'll get that shirt as like an homage to his greatness.
People,
but he needs to die.
Like all the games he's played, one was the first one where Bebop Vox tried to knock him out of bounds and kill him. He instead picked Attacker down, and Lil Skittles knocked his guy down. Then there was the second game where...
I like how you're like, the very first game I played against a guy who didn't really know what he was doing, and I kicked his ass.
It's Lil Skittles effect. And then there's the Skittles effect against Angry Joe, where he charged a guy at me, and right before Lil Skittles, he just fell down and injured himself. And then there was the third game where I played against... Who did I play against? I played against somebody. I think it was Side Strafe. Right, no, not Side Strafe. I played against somebody, and they tried to get Lil Skittles, and again... Oh, yeah, Gerard! I played against Gerard, and he tried to get Lil Skittles, and... It, like, started raining, and, like, friggin' what happened? He tried to use his wizard, and his game lagged, so he couldn't, and I was just like, Lil Skittles, lagging your game.
You can't say that about Gerard. Poor Gerard! Moved a guy three spaces, and his neck broke.
Gerard has, like, the worst luck in that game. It's pretty sad. And that's the Lil Skittles effect. Also... You can go to my YouTube, youtube.com/WildCrendor, twitter.com/WildCrendor, justlines.com/WildCrendor, buy my shirts, facebook.com/Crendor, and rodearcade.com/WildCrendor.
Oh yeah, and I said at the beginning of the broadcast that Ronimo gave me some game keys for Awesome Knots, and I had more than I could give away on Monday. So if you want a free copy of Awesome Knots, just tweet at @mindflame_awesomeknots, and after the broadcast I'm gonna favorite the winners, and then I will post what to do next to get your key.
All right, everybody likes free stuff unless they don't like free stuff.
Yes. Hey, I did grow a real mustache. Washington. Look back through the archive. Last fall I started growing a mustache, and I kept it for like 3 months. My wife hated it. So the draw it on one is better, because I can just...
Is that what she likes? Yeah. She likes the draw it on mustache.
Yes. She would much rather come home to this than a real mustache, which I can't get rid of.
Mm.
Well, it becomes sentimental at some point in your life.
You married a very forgiving woman.
Oh, yeah. Very. Trust me. I know. I don't know how she puts up with my shenanigans on a daily basis.
I can't even for like 2 hours.
That's the pool boy. Why pool boy or gardener, one of the two.
It'll be like people from that cat movie.
I like how only we get that. No one else understands how this.
That's the a talking cat movie that I need to watch.
Apparently. You need to watch it, because if you don't, you're missing out on life. Missing out on
a story
life.
Of Duffy the cat.
Duffy the cat. Duffy. And it's narrated.
No joke. He's played by the guy who's the gangster in The Dark Knight. Except he's drunk. Yeah. It's him with like a USB microphone doing the voice, drunk as shit.
And the audio's out of sync.
It's me, Duffy the cat.
There's one scene where the cat's like on a chair, and then he's like, Duffy, where are you from, little buddy? And then the cat's like, I'm Duffy the cat. And then he's like, oh wait, what's your name, Duffy? And he's like, I'm from over there. Like, it's just out of sync audio that they didn't line up properly.
You can see the laser pointer where they got the cat to move.
Yeah.
Cat it's treats. Amazing. It cost $1 million to make that film.
And I'm convinced they spent $950,000 of it on getting the guy to do the voice from The Dark Knight. I'm just saying.
Alright, we're done. This is over. We're done. Good shitty podcast.
Thanks for the invitation. It was good meeting you, Mark. And
yes, thanks for having me. I was happy to be here.
Mark, thank you. Jesse, you're yawning. And
thank you, everybody. I'm happy to have Mark here. Crendor, Clint, I'm going to get nasty messages from TB. Like, what the flying fuck just happened on that podcast?
Hey, we were a lot more on topic than the last time we were together. A lot more on topic.
I think I've forgotten about that.
You've repressed it because of how awful it was.
I need to go back and watch some of these podcasts because they sound entertaining.
There's some pretty good ones.
You could say that. You could say that. All right, we're done. Say bye, everybody.
Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.